today we actually have a very special speaker coming all the way from India. He has been involved in the work of conservation of medicinal plants in south of India for the last 15 years. Originally, he undertook the task of documenting these plants from the local knowledge, and he has since progressed to actually move on to doing lab works over the last 3 years to verify the effectiveness of these medicinal plants. I think some of you actually attended a talk that we had earlier this year by a French professor, Professor Christophe Wyatt, who actually has been in Malaysia for about 20 years. He also has been doing a lot of research on medicinal plants. And of course, one of the question marks in regards to medicinal plants is, you know, how effective are they? Do they really work? Okay. And I think we can get some great insight from our speaker for today on the work that has been done by our counterparts in India, and see how it is compared to our situation here in Malaysia. I think in Malaysia we are also facing many of similar issues, whereby the new generation, unfortunately like myself, we are not undertaking this task of trying to learn about the knowledge that our ancestors have been passing down over the generations. So unfortunately, this valuable knowledge might, disappear if nothing is done. So our speaker, Mr. Arumugam, actually has endeavored to make sure that all this knowledge is documented so that it's not lost for the future generation. So without much further ado, I'd like to invite our speaker for today, Mr. Arumugam from University of Madras, Chennai.
So I'm much thankful to the organizers for inviting me to MNSL to share my experience in terms of conservation of medicinal plants that has been carried out in India, particularly in South India, Pondicherry. So we all know that for the last decade, a lot of interest has been given to the medicinal plants because this is being supporting each and every issues man is facing this modern life. But what happens now, this is of late. A lot of species which has been found in the human domain that has been supporting the human being, several conditions, I mean diseases, all gone now. No more species. So what happened now? India, we face a lot of difficulties. Then we thought it's better to go for bringing the species as well as knowledge together, so that the future generation will have a base from which they can assimilate some of the information that would be useful for the posterity. Based on this particular outset, so I carried out my work with a team of people. So one Mr. Pierre is here. He is also part of the conservation of these medicinal plants, which we carried out in Oroville, which is the international city, which is being created in the UNESCO, I think by the year 1972. So afterwards, then I moved on to form a special society to address the conservation of medicinal plants and to popularize the medicinal plants for youngsters, in collaboration with the government of Pondicherry for 10 years. Then, for the last 3 years, I moved on to the University of Madras, Center for Advanced Studies in Botany, to do research on medicinal plants. How it is very effective, because many informations we have been taking from the tribal people and keep on recording, and most of the records are put into the bureau. Nobody is going to use that information. But I thought, it's better to take out one particular information, put it into the science, whether this information holding good for the humankind or not. So that particular information is anti-venom research, because a lot of very good areas are there, diabetes, cancer, so many things. But this particular information I picked up because it was so interesting for me. Because the situation where I come across to pick up this particular information from the tribal people was much fascinating towards me. So for the last 15 years, I've been holding my seed within myself. Then afterwards, a time has come for me to move on to the university. Now I'm working on the particular plant species culled out from the tribal community, is put for scientific validation, whether this is going to be a potential candidate to address the snake bite. As of now, the snake bite is being addressed only by a serum-mediated therapy, antibody. Antibody, you know, it's not a complete cure for the snake bites. Maybe it is cured, but afterwards, anaphylaxis, the side effects, the tissue damages, all very terrible thing, which cannot be cured by the antibody. But plant has got remedy. This is what tribal people have been using for the time immemorial. So that particular thing I'm working on. So that thing I will go ahead my thing. So in India, there are very codified streams. There are two streams of knowledge operating in India. One is codified stream, well-written documents. That is Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani, Amchi, and Tibetan. There is another stream which is also equally very good, holding very good information, that is non-codified stream, which is mainly operated by tribal community and traditional healers. If you call no, Pati Vaidyam and Natu Vaidyam, that's what we call it. So in India, about 8,000 species, of all these two streams, 8,000 species found to be used in the health system, then which is carried by 4,600 ethnic communities in India. And if you look at now, across the human being, veterinary, all the areas it's being used, is 8,000 species. So if you look at the scenario in India, about the 5,000 registered Indian system medicine manufacturing companies are operating in India, of which 90% of medicinal plants are supplied only from the forest. They don't have any cultivation field to support their industries. All the medicinal plants which are being used for the production of the medicines are taken only from the forest. But forest is the public domain. At the cost of public, the industries have been using these medicinal plants indiscriminately, and that leads to a lot of medicinal plants which is disappearing from the forest. So out of 400 species potentially used in the industries, only 40 species, maybe less than 40 species, are brought under cultivation. The rest are coming only from the forest ecosystem. So if you look at the threat assessment as per the IUCN, International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, based on the guidelines we operated to assess how the threat situation in India. So we come to know that 125 species are already facing lots of threats at various levels. Some species are critically endangered, some species wild extinct. Wild extinct in the sense, you cannot see any species in the forest. That particular condition is wild extinct. Some under critically endangered. Maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow, maybe after 1 year, 2 years, those species may be brought under that particular category, wild extinct. That is critically endangered, endangered, rare. Those categories, we come to know that there are 125 species in India which are in danger. So we need to have a Jurassic Park-like picture to see that this particular Orosalam indicum, I see in Malaysia a lot. That particular plant is one of the important medicinal plants which has been supporting to the very famous traditional medicine, that is Chyawanprash, in Himalaya Chyawanprash. So that particular Chyawanprash, the main ingredient, Nellika, that is Phyllanthus emblica, gooseberry. Phyllanthus emblica, gooseberry in English. Another important ingredient is Orosalam indica, that is, in Tamil it is Valpadri, I don't know Malay name. That particular plant has already gone out. So if you want to know, that particular plant you have to shoot the picture. Only then the future generation will know that Orosalam indicum was existing in this year, which has been supporting for the production of Chyawanprash Mandar. So the raw materials getting drastically reduced every year by year. leading to use of adulterant and substitutes. So now we have to agree that for the last decade, throughout the world, there is a positive sign to accept the herbal medicine for the healthcare. Earlier people have been, see one example I will tell you, earlier, suppose 30 years, 40 years back, in the rural people, those who are not having money power are using herbal plants. But now, the present situation, last 10 years, those who are having money are capable of going for this herbal medicine. The situation has been changed because very costly herbal medicine. The people who have been using those herbal medicines are not getting those access now, denied. The reason, all the rich people, elite people started realizing the importance of usage of health, the herbal medicinal plants, the health care, then which leads to not proper access to the owners of the knowledge, tribal people or local people. This is the situation. So in this situation, so we thought it's better to create a kind of a forum to bring all the species which are facing threats or the species which has been used for the tribal community having still validity in the human domain, all to put together. So what do we do? Can we be able to do conservation of entire globe? So as of now, I think not even 12% the tropical rainforest in the world. So I would say maybe 6 to 7%, that's the thing. The 6 to 7% of the tropical forest cannot be conserved. It's very huge, time consuming, money consuming. So what we thought, it is better to concentrate in 100 acres of land and give focus to conserve all the local species in the local area. Suppose for example, this is a care. So care situation, you start conserving the species which has been used by KL people in this KL region, all can be accommodated in 100 acres of land. These 100 acres will be arboring all the species of KL with the knowledge associated with the species also. So over a period of time, there is a constant evolution of plants and the knowledge. Then the more and more of information keep on building into your system, this will be the base and we'll be capturing entire knowledge of kale in 100 acres. That means the lost tradition will be brought into 100 acres in ex situ conservation. In ex situ conservation. So this will be going for future generation. So we thought it is an ethno-medicinal forest. Ethno-medicinal forest is a novel concept. Suppose if you want to create a botanical garden, look at the Singapore Botanical Garden or the Penang Botanical Garden. To maintain that Penang or Singapore Botanical Garden, it's very huge money consuming. We cannot be able to afford that much of money to conserve all the species. So in 100 acres of land, we need to bring ethno-medicinal forest concept in the sense to simulate the natural ecosystem where each and every plants are exercising their growth. For example, you bring trees, climbers, shrubs, herbs, epiphyte, those are the angles, elements, can be put it into natural way. So you need not maintain. Even 200 years, 300 years, without care it will be conserved. That sort of conservation is a novel concept, ethno-medicinal forest, which is an effective tool to bring knowledge as well as the species together for their posterity. That we attempted in 10 acres in Pondicherry, just as a model work involving all the stakeholders, traditional healers, the farmers, the tribal community, the NGO persons, the scientists, the student community, whatnot. All the people's been interacted in that particular 10 acres of land, and now it has grown like anything else without care. So this is the vision, the indigenous restoration of traditional cultural heritage. So this method is an effective method. I told you, not only brings a species, it restores the knowledge. This is the beauty of this thing. So for which, what is the steps we need to do? So simply we need to go for plant collection, germ blossom collection. So whatever area, whatever forest area, the reserve forest or visitor forest or reminiscent forest, wherever you find that the species are there, which is being used by the local people, you have to collect in terms of seeds, Not that, see, nowadays, you know, what happens, you know, people going to the forest to collect the larger seedlings. Don't collect the larger seedlings because you are destroying. Our aim is to create a forest in the human settlement, which would help us in understanding the growth, understanding the behavior, and that will be useful for future generation to transmit the traditional information. For which, you know, what happens, you know, people goes to the forest to pick up the large seedlings. Please don't do that. You pick up the seeds, collect the seeds, few seeds. Then you collect some cuttings, the stem cuttings or whatever. With that, you have to bring to your place and start propagating. See, this is one of the excursion team. So I had, last year, I went into a very big forest, that is one of the tiger reserve, Kallakkad Mundanthurai, Tirunelveli district south. That is one of the first tiger project which was started in Tamil Nadu. Very big forest, which may be equivalent to Amazon, with the component, no, in the forest, Agastya-Malay, can be equated, can be compared with the Amazon forest in terms of nutrient cycling, tiger, species diversity. This is one of the hotspot area. Most of the endemic species are harbored in this Kallakkad Mundanthurai Tiger Reserve. We got a special permission from the forest department to go for plant exploration. So we brought so much of the materials. So you can't, you don't have any shelter to stay there. You don't have any place to cook your food and eat. But you have to do all on the rock only. You have to carry foodstuffs with you, and you have to find a place where you can sleep in the night. While sleeping is a beauty, you have to fire in a circular form. And inside the fire, you have to sleep. So that no elephant and the tiger won't come and attack you. This is the way. So it's very risky but interesting, very natural way you have to do it. So after taking our foodstuffs, we are going to another site, shipping for collection. So this is how the species to be collected. Then, see, when you go for ethno-medicinal forest concept, collection of species, knowledge, everything, but as long as the species are supporting from wild state to the industry, we cannot be able to conserve the species, for which we need to go for cultivation of those species. We should stop cultivating plants from the wild state. Unless you stop collection from the wild state, you cannot conserve the species for the future generation. So what is the alternative ways? You need to address cultivation of those species which are supporting the industries. So what are the criteria? Prioritize your species selection. So first priority, plants having wider application in both ISM and modern system. Wider application, both in ISM and modern health system. Then plants which are endangered and threatened in the wild habitats, very facing threats in the forest ecosystem, those species to be brought in and cultivated. Then third thing, plants which have greater demand and short in supply, maybe large demand, for example, Orosella mendica, very large demand, but short in supply, that is why people are going for substitutes. Those kind of species need to be cultivated. Then fifth category, plants which are used in large number of formulations. And base for all. See, if you go for ethno-medicinal knowledge, if you go for tribal community, ethno-medicinal knowledge. The ethno-medicinal knowledge is the base for modern drug discovery. Many drugs, no, which has been supporting human being in allopathy have come from the ethno-medicinal survey. Because in the world there are 250,000 angiosperms, flowering plants. As of now in the world, not even 6% of the floras have been explored for their active principles. This is a situation, it's very costly, time consuming. So it's a clue for us, the biotechnologists, the researchers, the ethno-medicinal informations are base for further research for drug development. In that way, we have been doing the drug development in which this particular information, I'll tell you, this is Caralluma attenuata, which comes in the dry hill areas in India, South India. When we go for plant collection in the hot sunny days, we need to take the stem, we'll cut the stem and take it and eat it to quench the thirst, to quench the thirst. So what happens? This information has been culled out from the tribal people, and I am the victim now. I just transferred into a biotech company when they've been looking for one plant for to work out a drug for slimness, body slimness. They found very interesting compound. It's the first of its kind. And they patented, if you eat this particular stem, your body will be slim. So USA, which is being marketed, body, that is commercial name is Slimolimma. So I have been teaching our tribe, our local people, self-help groups, that women groups, which has been potential carriers of the knowledge. We have been giving training to the women groups to take this particular stem to reduce your body bulky mass. They never mind, because it's very easy, like this. Okay, the next year shift into 80 plants, 20 plants. This information has been culled out, documented by the scientist in the institution. Then they come out, very useful component. Then it has been formulated as a Jeevaniya. It's a medicine, Jeevaniya, health promoting medicine. This is the only one which fetch intellectual property, right? Then subsequently, some sort of profit has been shared to the community whom this information has been taken out. I'll tell you, I'll show the plant afterwards. This is the plant, Trichopus zalanicus, variety zalanicus. So where the serious plants, not more than this height from the forest floor. So fruits will be there. I think this particular plant doesn't have fruits. You can take, but now what happens now? The leaf also being used, because fruit, no, one or two fruits will be there. It's endemic, nowhere else in the world. Only in India, nowhere else in the world. This is called endemic. So now, you know, to have the farmers, the better understanding. See, if you create the ethno-medicinal forest without addressing any stakeholders, it is not going to be protected after you leave the site. So instead, you bring all the stakeholders, you bring the traditional healers who have been nurturing this kind of living tradition, you bring the farmers who have been cultivating, you bring the students, all the people should be brought inside and discuss with them and make a commitment with them, involved in the conservation process, then this will be useful and it's a permanent one. So that's how the farmers from various places in the Pondicherry brought in, and we have been discussing what sorts of plants to be cultivated and how many acres you will be offering to cultivate this one. Then it's very easy to tell you people to cultivate this one. I can tell you, okay, Trichopus zalanicus, you cultivate in 100 acres. After the cultivation of 100 acres, what will happen to the plants? Who will come and procure? Because medicinal plants, it's not a food plant. Suppose if I cultivate rice, 100 acres, there are agencies to lift the rice. But if I cultivate these medicinal plants, who are the people to come and lift? Nobody will come. After the harvest, no? When people will come in, okay, I want 110 of this material, you cultivate. Then you cultivate. Afterwards, no? People won't come for picking up the material. And you will be keeping in your house. How long will you keep 110 of material? Then tomorrow one person will come. He himself will send another person. Okay, you won't ask that I is storing 110 of material. You won't ask. Maybe originally he might have committed for 100 ringgit per kilo. Then this guy will go and ask, can you give me 5 rupees, 5 ringgit? What to do? He should not keep for a long time in his house. He doesn't have a space also. Then he is forced to give for 5 ringgit. So 10 ringgit to 5 ringgit, that guy getting. So it's better to go for contract farming, agreement. Yes, this, bank guarantee. So we have been doing this kind of thing in India, bank guarantee. So you are the trader, I'm the farmer, the bank will give guarantee to the farmer. Yes, irrespective of you take or not, the bank will give me the money once it is harvested. And you will be giving surety to the bank. So fine. This is how all the things will be worked out only in the meeting. Here farmers are there, bank managers, he is the bank manager. So many people are involved in the process. That's how it should be taken out. So again, there's no medicinal plants that has been taken. So this on particular information why I bring now, this is a very famous traditional bone setting plant. I don't know whether you have this kind of information in India, still in the rural areas, the kettles, the veterinaries, when bone is broken, so it's not brought into the hospital. Even, see, I am standing here very healthy. I met with maybe 10 accidents in my life in the botanical exploration. So according to doctor's certificate, they said I cannot be able to trek because my bone, patella, hand, everything is broken. What happened? After 3 months of diamond, you don't believe me, I went into a trekking to the forest by walking. After coming down, I went and told to the doctor, "Doctor, I come from the Kollikeres." My, okay, don't go to the Kollikeres and all, you be here in the home. Maybe for the relaxation, you went into a car. No, doctor, I didn't go by car, I went into the plane. From plane, I trekked all the height. What a crazy guy. Then afterwards, he said, okay, you can walk here afterwards. Because with help of these things, the traditional bone-setting medicinal plants, Harmocarpum senoides. So these kind of informations are there in the people's domain. Osteoporosis. After the menopause, see, lot of calcium phosphorus depletion. The bone is becoming very weaker. So you take these leaves, so which is full of calcium phosphorus, which strengthen your bone. It's very good. So you have to think of other areas also. Because always there is a contradiction between the allopathic and the traditional. People know, because they have studied 5, 6 years, 10 years, they put all their efforts in the lab, no? All of a sudden, a traditional healer comes and says, I have medicine for AIDS. Nobody believes. But of course, he has got medicine. Nobody believes. This is the way. So the time will come to have a compromise, to understand, they realize the importance of traditional medicine. Only then the thing will work. So for which, no, you need to have a kind of nursery. Nursery is the heart of your plantation program. You should have quality nursery. The arrangement you see, the shade net, everything properly you have to maintain. Only that the seedling qualitatively will be producing. Then you can supply to the farmers, you can supply to the needy people, whoever comes, you can give. This is the Slimolima plant, you see. I produce 1 lakh plants. 1 lakh. Slimolima, mainly to distribute to the householders. Each and every household come, just pay 1 rupee, 1 seed, 1 rupee. I don't know how much in cent Malay. 1 rupee, Indian money, 1 rupee per seedling. So you take 10 plants, 15 plants, tack, tack, tack. That is how, very cheaper. So most of the students, school groups. See, I'll tell you, most of the weeds, you know, you understand, I think I also seen there. The weed plant may be a beautiful flower once you come to know. I think the message is there in the down. What I am saying now, most of the weeds are medicinal plants. You may be finding that this is useless. That has got high medicinal value. In India, we'll be having one plant, a thorn, 5-6 sized thorn, that is called the Tribulus terrestris. If you go on barefooted, it will stick onto your foot. You throw it out. But what happens now, that is high medicinal value. That is for urinary trouble, kidney, stone breaker. Understand? So most of the weed plants are having medicinal qualities. So unless the young generation, the student communities are educated that the weedy plants you consider as weed are having high medicinal value, they never respect the plant. They never respect. Then what happens? We orient the student communities exposed to the site, explain each and everything. And in Tamil Nadu, there is another thing. If you buy new schools, no, once it's open, they will give you books and notes wherein they will paste one label, write the name of the candidate, the book, the subject and all. The label will be pasted on the book after making a record. What happens in our place, they will be making the label after the actor or actress. Rajinikanth, Kamal Kasan, maybe Rajinikanth you are aware. Then our actress Kushpu or something like that. But we intervened in this particular junction, printed label with Tribulus terrestris, that is VD plant, Mimosa pudica, tribal plant. Just name of the plant, uses, part use, part for. Simple message. It's being given to the students. At this age, when they come to know the importance of these VD plants, definitely when they grow up, in future, at least they may become a politically sound person in future, they'll have this kind of information, they'll look for making kind of measures to safeguard. Otherwise, no, these people also, you know, in Tamil, no, there is one plant, I don't know, people are here, somebody else, Adathoda, most of the cup syrup which is being manufactured in this modern life, one particular plant, Adathoda vesica, Adathoda, which is called Tamil, without Adathoda, no herbal cup syrup. But how many of the young kids going to the schools are knowing that Adathoda is having such a property? Nobody knows. So unless you educate the youngsters, the school going, nothing you can bring out. So again, I told you about the polycultural method. This is one important method. Polycultural method of planting trees, shrubs, climbers. Simulate the natural ecosystem. So to understand the simulating a natural ecosystem, you must know the biotic association of each and every plant. That means, if you look at one tree here, what are the plants associated along with that? That you must understand. Not that the particular useful plant alone you cultivate, you said it is conserved. It's not correct. Maybe to bring one useful plant, two, three non-useful plant also to be brought inside, only in that ambience this grows very well. So in order to bring out ethno-medicinal forest concept, you must know the biotic association of each and every species that you are going to bring and introduce into the in-situ site. This is a very important thing. Over a period of time, over a period of experience only, you can come to know what sort of biotic association each and every plant is being keeping down. It's very important aspects. So traditional healers, see this particular traditional healer. So I've been referring. So this is the important traditional healer in my life, because he is the man showing, see this wood, which is used for snake bite. He is showing this plant, this is used for a snake bite, and he is holding another plant, snake bite. It's a traditional recipe. This particular information he has been keeping from his forefathers years together. Oral tradition, no written tradition. Maybe I'll be referring to transferring to my son or daughter. Then again, he'll be telling to his son or daughter, no outsiders. But maybe I'm the breakers. He passed on these information to me, trusting me that I'll be using for the beneficial, that is useful ways. So this particular information. It's good for tribal thing, tribal information, good for snake bites. Especially it is good for cobra and razor viper. These two species, the snake venom only, I am going to test it out with this formulation, whether this is working or not. So finally, if this particular recipe is working very well for the snake bite, definitely it will work out the modalities, how to share the profit to the this guy. When I start giving profit to this guy, many people from the community will come. No. This information not exclusively belongs to him. This belongs to a community. Then you have to consider the whole community together and work out the modalities, strategies, how information is to be passed on to them. Only then he will be happy. Then I will be happy. Otherwise, I will be doing injustice to him. This is another guy recently come across. This guy is a specialist for snake bites. He has got things in the capsule. What he says now, astonishing, amazed. So take 5 capsule. Take 5 capsule. Put it into 30 ml of cold water. You shake very well. Then give to him. In half an hour, snake bite is cured. Half an hour, snake bite is cured. It's challenging. What sort of person? Nowadays, it's a very big problem to treat the venomous snake bites. But this man is saying, take 5 capsules, put it into the water, 30 ml of cold water, shake it very well, then consume. Snake bite is cured, especially cobra and
any snake.
Yes, no, only 2 species.
Venomous.
Only 2 species, yes. Cobra and razor viper. How? So this information to be validated scientifically. I'll take 1 minute, just little diversion.
About cultivation one and the wild one, potency is same, not different. Wild one and the cultivate one.
That is another story.
Another story.
That is another story. Huh. That what a story is that, because a medicinal plant which is coming from the wild state are having high vigorous. The vigor is very high.
Yeah.
The same plant when it is cultivated in the field, it may not be having that sort of property.
Yeah.
So how long will be saying the same thing? That's what my question. People have been saying, if you take this particular concept to the traditional healer, they will be saying, no, don't cultivate. you have to take medicinal plants only for the forest. If you cultivate, the vigor will be lost. Okay, I'll be asking the same question. How long? You have depleted so much of resources. Again, you will be depleting so much of resources, saying the same concept. So what is the solution for that? What is alternative remedies? So I am saying, if you take 10 grams of the wild medicinal plant, you take 20 grams of the cultivated source. Matter is simple. Or go for doing research. Understand? Find out the optimum dose. So unless we do, we cannot be able to safeguard the precious the medicinal plants. It will be wiped off. So coming to this point now, this guy, what he says, this one, no, the particular area I was coming. Most of the traditional healers, if you go and talk now, they'll say, I have treated 100 patients of snake bites. If you look at us, only one person died, you might be saying. Only one person died. I would say that, I'm pessimistic. I'm saying, the one person who died is might be due to poisonous, venomous snake bite. The 99% he has cured might be due to non-poisonous snakes. I doubt my knowledge, because I need to go ahead. Might be true also. But this fellow is very strongly says, yes, I get cured. Then I had spoken to many people. Those he has been cured, no? He has been keeping record. Then I spoke to those people, whether you got this kind of things and all. He said, yes. With Ram Prasad Vaidya, we take 5 capsules dissolved in 30 ml of water, which was very good to cure the snake bite. This is how people are saying, good living certificate. So I am taking this particular medicine for my validation part. So again, the schools, most of the schools in our Pondicherry state, no, we'll be having a program that is School Herbal Garden. So we will be taking around 20 to 30 plants, which are very essential to address the simple health care for headache, for fever, dysentery, diarrhea, skin disease. These kind of issues, you need not go to the allopathic hospital. Don't go to the allopathic hospital for purchase of sardine or anacin or paracetamol. When you come across, you take Tyrospora cardifolia, it's a climbing plant, take the stem, cut into, put little bit of ginger. You have got Malaysia's got full of ginger, very healthy ginger when compared to India. No, I found very healthy ginger. Take one piece of ginger, make a decoction, boil it, filter it, consume it. It's very good for fever. So no need to go to the hospital to buy one paracetamol. Similar, lot of, like that, 30 plants, bundle it as a package, we'll be giving to schools, wherever empty space like this there, we'll be involving students to go for bringing herbal garden in the schools. That means, no, 30 plants information is being given to the people. And any time, whenever they come across any problem, they will take these plants and use it. But we'll be giving training. We'll be giving training. Maybe 1 hour I cannot be able to give you everything. I'm just giving you, but in India, when we go to the classroom, I'll be taking all the equipment, stove, vessels, that everything I'll be keeping. Then I'll demonstrate how a kashaya to be prepared, how much one has to drink. All the informations I'll be giving to them. Then subsequently, when they come across this particular issue, they will consume. Then eco-friendly. No. You're saving money and you're saving your health. Because when you go for allopathy, tomorrow there will be another problem. So that is not going to be here. And third thing, when you cultivate medicinal plants, you are addressing the national concern. Green. At many level, you are addressing the simple issue in a very humble way with having herbal garden, the school gurus. This is one of the important plants, very important plants, Western Ghats species. Very important plants. Nowadays people will be having a knee problem. So knee problem, old people may be having the knee problem. This will be having a lot of problems, that enzyme problem, all the things. So this one, we will be telling people, take the leaves, make a soup. So Malaysia is famous for soup. Whenever you go, I've been delighted to have soup here. So they will add leaves, then you will be having other way, pepper, piper, nigrum, then garlic, then some tomato. This all crush ginger. Then make a decoction, drink it slowly, continuously, maybe weekly once or twice, whenever you get time, then your problem will be addressed. Very simple herb, very common herb. This is called as a Kadaba fruticosa. Kadaba, C-A-D-A, Kadaba.
Locally available here.
Huh?
locally available in Malaysia. No.
I have not seen this one. Sorry, I have not seen this one.
Not in Malaysia.
I have not seen one. Even two, three forests I have been, I have not seen one. Because this is there in these drier areas.
Drier.
Not in the wet evergreen, full rainfall areas.
Yeah.
Dry areas. Maybe in dry areas we should see this one. See, again this one, sir. Equatorium triplinar V. This is for any pyes disease. Pyes, you know, pyes is concerned, no? The body heat and all. You'll be having so much of problem. The fissures and the blood leakage while you go for motion and all, no? That, this particular plant is the Equatorium triplinar V. Very good. Simply, you can take 2-3 leaves, that's all. 2-3 leaves. Which is not so bitter also. Then this one is a very ornamental one. I think we have seen in Malaysia, one of the Malaysia it is there, this plant. Malaysia it is there. So these two are very good for pines. And this particular thing, the leaf, no, you can eat as you can eat as a, even as a fresh leaf. This is a Jeevanthi. In India, if you tell Jeevanthi, Jeevanadi, the immortal. If you start taking this particular plant now, you will be, your system will be rejuvenated. That's how we call it. So we take this one as a leafy vegetables. We just cut and take like that. And even the tuber also very good. You can take the tuber out and you can consume this one. So why I'm saying now, these are the species which have been found in the evergreen forest in the Western Ghats. In Pondicherry state, we didn't have any forest. Maybe in India, only state without forest, Pondicherry, my own state, no forest. But what happens, after having this program, Ethno-Medicinal Forest Concept Introduction, we could conserve 600 plant species. So now, Pondicherry, in 10 acres, we have got so much of species. So now it is being conserved. Now I'm saying the point, you can say, it is conserved, in the sense, no, even for 100 years, this particular plant will produce seeds. This particular plant will give you planting material, cuttings. So it is not wiped off. Maybe in the forest, Western Ghats, it will be wiped off. But in 10 acres, it won't be wiped off because this is getting protection from the people. All the people are giving protection. The farmers, traditional healers, students, teachers, researchers, everybody is giving protection. So this won't go away from the people's domain. This is the beauty of the ethno-medicinal forest concept. Then same thing, this one. So this particular plant, no, in the old palmscrit, we had in India, we have had a lot of palmscrit, that in the palm leaf, all the important legends have been written down. So for writing on the palms, this flower yield a kind of blue dye. This dye will be applied on the palm leaf. Afterwards, only they will be writing on that. That is why these letters have been preserved even 5,000 years. See the beauty, this particular thing. How many people now, the present generation, knows that the palm leaf has got this particular flower, dye is being applied. So unless you have this kind of concept, no, you cannot enjoy, you cannot satisfy the future generation. You have to convince the future generation, only then they will understand. Then
you mean the Buddhism, the Sutta, they write on the palm leaf?
Palm leaf, yes. Palm leaf,
the
no.
The Sutta, the India, Buddhism one.
Ternatia clitoriaga.
Not Clitoria ternatia.
No.
Clitoria ternatia is not at all. This one, Mimisilon umbellatum. Tamil is called Kasambu.
The dala.
The flower. And one more thing, this leaf, no. I'm the first man who propagated this particular plant for consumption in Pondicherry. In the sense, no. Once I was traveling in the forest, I have been looking at this plant, what is this, this. Then I will, because we botanists know, always will be keeping a lens, that this and that, what species, stamen, all that thing, you will be analyzing. The one tribal fellow has come, what you are doing here? I said, I'm just identifying what it is. Okay, you do your thing, come. He brought handful of leaf, you take, eat. I said, no, is it edible? No, you take. He was very angry, when I refused to eat, you take. Then I find the beauty, it is sweet taste. He says, if you keep on eating this one, your body will be strength. Your system is regenerated. Then only, he told the story, how this is pumped, everything. Then I go back into the library, refer whether this particular plant has got any applications to protect the palm leaf and all. It's found, it's true. Now how come you deny this intake also go wrong. So tribal informations, no, I'll tell you, the tribal informations, the local informations are practical ecological knowledge. If any particular information is not holding good to the human being, it's not working, that will wipe off that particular period itself. It won't continue for another 100 years. Now I'm talking to you, my talk or my information is not useful to you before leaving this hall, no, just you will throw it out and go. If it is good, no, you will continue. Similarly, the practical ecological knowledge is concerned, unless this is not holding good, it won't be kept. So we have strong belief that this practical ecological knowledge, tribal knowledge, has got very good validity. Only thing, we the modern people should look into each and every plant with our own science and prove, yes, this is working well. This is the beauty that we have to do it. The future scientist, the biotechnologist, then this will be the holistic way we are dealing with traditional information. This is there in Malaysia, Orosa elementica. See, this what you see now is the aloe vera. Aloe vera. Aloe vera, no, nowadays, no, what happens? According to me, according to, I've been telling, see, a medicinal plant which has got one property, maybe medicinal value, or cosmetic value, or food value. But this aloe vera has got three in one. Such a nature's gift in India, what happens, maybe 10 years before, I used to find this particular plant at the entrance of the house, hanging to ward off evil spirit. This is the way this has been used. And most of the new cars, when it is bought in India, they will put on top of the, on front of the vehicle, to ward off the lemon fruit, this aloe vera, then so much of chilies, all that things. So I've been telling people, yes, such a great nature's gift, aloe vera, which has got all the three in one, which is not for just superstitious belief and faith alone. You eat, it's very good. See, I would say, which has got so much. See, human being requires 24 amino acids. Am I correct? 24 amino acids, out of which 18 amino acids this aloe vera has got. It has got all the vitamins, minerals, nutrients, and more than 200 enzymes. What happens in Malaysian situations, I need to tell. Most of the people are eating fast food. Okay, but one good thing I find, no, you are all eating a lot of leafy vegetables and vegetables. It's a compensator. Unless that particular part, no, you will be very, very miserable. But still, I'll tell you, you need a lot of enzymes. These enzymes, how do you get, no? When you eat the aloe vera-like plant, the fresh plant, you have to take, without cooking, you have to take. That has got lots of enzymes. That is the reason the traditional food has been very healthy. Nowadays, we are not taking anything else. Everything cooked. Very fast food chemicals, that and all. That's the reason. So this aloe vera, we first time in Pondicherry made into people's health drink. I again got this formula from the tribal community. I conceived this formula. I took this aloe vera, very healthy leaf, cut the leaf, take the pulp out, add some ingredients. That is piper longum, piper nigrum, then gingiber officinal, suku. I don't know, these three ingredients. Then three more ingredients, nellikai, gooseberry, kadukai, Tenellia bellerica, then Tenellia cebola, these three. Then little pinch of elachi powder, that is cardamom, little powder. Then palm sugar, not white sugar, palm sugar. If you add now, nicely you can take the drinks and be popularized. Everywhere if you go to Pondicherry now, I made a point now, the people who are going to the college, 3-4 people should be pulled off and I will be training how to make this drink and take him to the Sunday, whatever Sunday, where people are assembled morning hours. He sell out 500 rupees. The ingredients, no, first 3 months I will be supporting, our society was supporting. He takes every money. Then afterwards, no, happily he comes and sit for two hours, earn 500 rupees, spend the ingredients and all some 100 rupees, carry 400 rupees, go to the college, study. Then it is going to the self-help groups and post office, everywhere now people start taking aloe health drink. So earlier this one was made into only to ward off evil spirits, and in front of the car they will tie and to this tree, something like that. Now such a medicinal plant, this is how each and every plant should be looked into, attended very carefully, popularized to the level people accept. That all the things possible. Only you have an effective conservation site, arboring all the species, constant interaction, they will believe, youngsters will believe. Older people will come forward, happily transfer the information that this group is doing wonderful work. This is again, you know, my country. Aloe vera? Yeah, I'll tell you that recipe. Maybe end up with that.
No, aloe vera.
Aloe vera. Aloe vera.
Any species?
Aloe barbadensis. Huh? I have been seeing Malaysia a lot.
Some aloe vera leaves are because spots one. Is it also can
No, take, aloe vera without any spines. There are three species.
No, spine. They got spots, white spot. That one is can take orally.
Yes. Aloe vera.
Don't care any species lah. Just aloe vera.
Aloe vera. What I have been seeing in Malaysia, aloe vera is there. No other species.
I know some got two
then
or
one
three.
Species aloe foxy that is there in the USA. Uh-huh. And one more species I forgot now.
I have one in my garden. They got white patches.
White spot is there? No, that is aloe barbadensis aloe vera. That is very good. That one you should allow to
but
grow.
But the leaf is very small one.
Yeah, that's what it's I'm telling you. I'm coming to that particular point. You have to keep only one plant in one pot.
Why?
One plant in one pot, allowing the plant should to exercise grow. The full growth. Okay. What happens, I see, they keep 10 plants, 15 plants together, it won't grow.
Yeah.
It won't grow
very
exercise.
Small.
It is very small. Yeah. You have to get at least one leaf, 500 gram in weight. You can get even 1 kg in one leaf. If you cut the leaf, the gel inside gel is not very touchy.
Yeah. Just eat the jar on it.
I'll tell you, again, you take the 2-inch size, cut it, transverse, take the gel out, and put it into water. Again, people will be saying, no, you got to wash 5 times, 6 times, 10 times. No need to, because earlier, 100 years back, 50 years back, 10 years back, people have been collecting this plant only from the forest. Forest, no, in summer season, if you collect, the plant looks pinkish color, reddish color. Reason is that when there is no enough water, it produces a lot of alloying content, very bitter content. That is giving you reddish color. Once here, now we brought into cultivation stage. We are putting a lot of water. Always the plant looks green in color. Once you look, this is green in color, you collect the leaf, cut the thing, take the gel out, immediately you put it into the mixer. Okay, then you buy in the traditional shops, pepper, that is long pepper, that is gingerbread, dried ginger, everything is there. You mix it, keep it one container. You take 1 teaspoon. Then another thing, gooseberry, pilantha simplica, then Terminalia cebula, Terminalia ballerica, everything is there. You make powder, keep it one container. You take 1/2 teaspoon, right? Then 100 to 100 ml palm sugar, depending upon your taste, palm sugar. You just crush, put it in the water, then pour into the mixing. Then only 1 pinch of cardamom, elachi powder, you just add into that. Maybe 1/2 lemon fruits, just squeeze it. Right? Ready. Close the mixer, on it. Within 2 minutes, it's ready. Okay, you take at least 1 glassful. Anytime you can drink, no time. Then people will say, yes, if I start taking continuously this aloe vera juice, no, I'm getting cold sinus and all. Yes, the cold sinus is coming to you. It's not the problem with the aloe vera. It's a problem with your system. Been taking lots of alkaline acidic food which has been accumulated in the system, all that is being expelled out. So it will be there for 2-3 weeks. That's all. Then afterwards, it will be normalized, acclimatized. Till that thing, don't be panic. Aloe vera doesn't have any harm effect. Everything is useful. Pardon?
I heard that aloe vera is a natural steroid elements inside.
Aloe vera? Nothing, because I'm saying the alloyin is the only component. Alloyin. 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 It is a bitter one, alloyin. This particular one, when you pluck the aloe vera, you just cut it, you just hang it for a few minutes. All the alloyin will be drained. All the alloyin will be drained. But this exercise you have to do only when you go for food consumption. When you use it as a medicine, maybe you want to cut a wound on your skin, no? Don't do that. That alloyin is a medical property.
That's the one that they say is
the yes, which is drained out, yellowish one, that has got high medical property.
So we need to drain that out?
Drain, before consuming. Just drain out, all the things will be out. then you put it. Very good. And only some people, it has got some kind of allergy. But most of the people doesn't have. But those who face that kind of problem, they just hang for 2-3 minutes. You just decant the yellowish alloying, then you can go for consumption. When you add this traditional recipe, you know, all the thing I'm telling you, know, that will neutralize all the residues of aloe vera scotch. That's a beauty, traditional formula, colored from the tribal people. Then this one is a noni. This one everybody knows. Noni health drink. Noni health drink. If you see the India, no, all the people who are been sleeping, no, they will be running the advertisement. Because the knee problem, all the world problem, everything is being addressed. This noni health drink. And we in India, we had another species, Morinda pubescens. This is Morinda sativifolia. Morinda pubescens is there, which you can eat as such. I'm telling, this 1 liter is costing about how much? 1,200 rupees.
Very sour.
1,200 rupees. You forget about the sour taste and all. 1,200 rupees, this noni health drink. I am telling you, you grow this noni tree plant, take 5 fruit, that put it into 1 liter of water, just to squeeze it, take the seeds and other debris out, okay? Filter it, or just take it out. You add the required quantum of palm sugar, heat it little bit warm, then consume. The 5 fruit is costing 1,200 rupees.
Tastes
which
like,
has got everything.
Tastes like cat vomit.
Which has got everything, sir. Everything. Holistic. So, this is how we need to propagate this information. Yeah, this is aloe vera. See, you have to order like this. One. If you put together, no, it won't exercise this thing.
Just like that, eat raw can.
Eat raw, you can take. I'll take as such raw. I don't want to put it into all the traditional recipes. I'll just take the gel and eat.
Then the outside skin, they're not.
Skin, eat. Don't waste it. The skin also don't pour. Then? Because this kahi, when you dry it out, in India we used to make herbal shikakai, herbal shampoo. Okay. You add into that. Herbal shampoo, when you prepare, you add into that. Hibiscus flower, then this leaf. Then acacia poinsettia, that is shikakai, and many ingredients you just add and make powder, apply, the foam will be there. It's very good for dandruff, anti-dandruff, anti-dandruff. Very good, aloe vera, everything is useful.
You mean to say that aloe vera, you know the when you cut it, or you put it in, they call the sap,
the sap
sticky one.
Sticky, that you drain it.
Oh.
That, actually the another beauty is there.
Medical value.
That's it.
The German also can take directly.
Which one?
In early morning, I wake up.
Empty stomach, you can take it. In India, wow, we will take, no? We will put it in the buttermilk. Buttermilk.
Sap also can take one.
Sap. I think you ought to know your prakriti, your body condition, only then you should take. But as a food, when you
go for it,
again, something different, I need to go through each and every body condition, whether you can take this aloe sap or not, you should assess the end, only then you have to take. Safely, you decant that alloy in, that yellowish liquid, then take the gel, that you take empty stomach, or you put it in the buttermilk. Buttermilk.
Moru.
Moru. Buttermilk. You take it, very good. Actually, in Tamil it is called Kumari. Kumari, it is woman friendly. Many issues, no, it's very good for aloe vera. Aloe vera is such a
wonder herb.
Yeah. This is what I was saying, body slimness. This one. That is Caroluma. Caroluma. See how the woman, how they are taking aloe leaf, no? They are preparing aloe herb drink. They are cutting down the leaf, taking out the pulp, and preparing this. Then landscaping. I will come to this point. I am very happy, I am very glad that I am in Malaysia, because everywhere it is greenery, right kind of species have been brought into the streets, and is one very good thing I have been observing. But in India, I don't know, maybe, the landscape concepts, you know what I am referring, and the roadside plantations, on the school campus or anywhere else, the park, the garden, whatever you create, everywhere you can see, maybe I would say 80% exotic plants. You know exotic plants, species not native to that particular locale, it has come from other area. Maybe it has come from USA, maybe it has come from Australia, it has come from Africa, but not your own plant. What happens? Then you will be, people will be asking, I've been addressing this question. Okay, try to plant indigenous plant species on the roadside, for avenue trees, for recreational area, for everything, do it. Don't put exotic plants. Then people started asking me, why are you against the plants? We are not here to discriminate people even. You are going to discriminate plant species. Sorry, my dear, I'm not telling like that. I'll tell you the science behind that. If you go and look at the eucalyptus plantation underneath, do you see any plants are growing? And the, all the leaf litter materials which are fallen, it takes years together to get decomposed. Why? It is allelopathic effect. Some sort of exotic plants when you add into your system, your insects, your earthworm, your microorganism, fungus, bacteria, all are starved and not given the sufficient food. The litter materials which is fallen on that are given sufficient food. They eat. In turn, they convert the leaf into the assimilable nutrients. In turn, the plant absorbs and we are getting the fruits, the grapes. It's a natural ecosystem which has been maintaining. We have to solid the natural, the microorganisms. Unless the microorganisms are not there, the whole world may not be fit for the human being. So this such a concept which is hidden into that, which is simply taking care. If you look at one American scientist has evaluated, calculated the ecosystem services which is being offered to the earth, which is equivalent to $33 trillion. We have to pay. All these services are we are getting from the natural, from the microorganisms. So we are doing a lot of research studies. These hibiscus flowers. So in these hibiscus flowers, we have been making a beautiful syrup. Very beautiful syrup out of that. Then we will drink. I think it is a national flower. We also start enjoying the hibiscus flower and make a beautiful herb drink.
Any color of the flower.
A flower, you will get the
color.
Only this one.
Yeah, some other color.
White, the red one.
Some other color.
Not some other colors. Not two. Wild one. Five petals. One, two, three, four, five petals. There are multi petals, which is not a medicinal value. Five petals only medicinal value. White is not medicinal value. Not colors. See, a lot of people from various places, comes and visits, documents, interact. They also go with enthusiasm to go and do this kind of model in other places. Yeah. Thanks a lot. Any doubt, any queries, please welcome.
Do you have any questions? Are you doing any work here?
No. I am actually my friend here. Is that we work together. So he's here in Malaysia. He's a GI specialist. So every year I visit and stays with him and go around the streets and go to the Botanical Garden, Penang. And earlier I've been working for the Malaysian government to establish similar concepts to this. Some six visits. Most of my friends, well-wishers. Everybody is sponsored.
Well, why the Malaysian government are keen so...
No, actually it's very difficult to move the government now. To see in the party people, just you allow people to interact, then in a consensus you can arrive. But without meeting the people, just concept alone going across the mind, how people will perceive how it is important and all. It's not possible. That's why you need to address to the people, then people has to take forward these kind of concepts. Not the politicians. It's very difficult. Sorry, my friend is going to go.
I see quite a scary phenomenon here is lately, everyone is talking about herbal medicine.
Okay.
But I see two things very worrying. Number one, they don't really know how to identify the species. I see a lot of people consuming the wrong species.
Yes.
That's it's really scary.
Yeah, I understand. That's the biggest problem now. That's why each and every species now I just portrayed now. What happened now in my place, when I go for training to people, I will take all the live plant with me. Maybe 10 plants I'm going to teach the people. 10 plants I'll be carrying with them. And sometimes I'll be asking people to my center. I'll show them first.
Do you have any...
huh? I have a lot of plants.
You don't have the history.
My laptop, no, lot. I think that.
Show us some.
So I need to take to them. Unless you know the right plant you are referring, it's very difficult because most of the plants look like similar.
Especially here, the diversity is so high.
Yeah. Diversity, people, yeah, very high. Yeah, very it's high. Confused.
Yeah, so I see a lot of people here say, you know, it's really scary. And the second thing is, a lot of people do not understand traditional knowledge need to be learned. A lot of people, you know, like the traditional way of consuming, like
yes,
the
yes,
you
yes.
share with us. People just take the species and consume it the modern way. Some people just say blend it and drink, which is really risky. They do not know what they consume. Does it happen?
See, two things I'll tell you. Yeah. One thing, the young people are not having mind to follow the traditional way. People immediately will say, no, what is this? I have to take the leaf, take the pulp out, add pepper, ginger, that, this. It's a fast world. I'm going to take one tablet and keep going. Why should? This is the attitude now. The second thing, the people whom this information is documented, it should be properly documented, not haphazardly. You have to properly document it in a proper way, traditional way it should be consumed. Because we don't know. Might be 5-10 plants together when it is added, according to the proportion how you documented, similar way you should consume. Because one plant, if you have more of quantum, the synergetic effect, no, the formula may differ also. So we don't know. That's what I told you, no, the practical ecological knowledge which has been passed on generation after generation, it is holding well. That is why we have been following. Suppose one particular information is not holding good to the people, it would have been thrown out in the dustbin. It would not continue for 5,000 years. We are talking about 5,000 history, 5,000 years back.
Can you comment on the use of papaya leaves for dengue?
Papaya is quite useful. A lot of various people have been doing. Even in papaya, no? One example I recently come across, papaya, and people extract alkaloids from the papaya. Instead of going for the leaf as such, they will cultivate only to cull out the papain, that alkali. From there, they will be going for anesthesia. Many things is going for modern medicines.
How about the
Gawa leaf? Gawa leaf.
Goa. Goa is very good. A simple thing I'll tell you. Leaf, I'll tell you. Simple thing. How the documentation is very beautiful. You just any teeth, no?
It smells good. Yeah.
Teeth, no? Which is having a decay. Oh. Simply, you take the guava leaf, then squeeze it, just masticate your thing. Then you just gargle it. The worm inside, no, will come out. What a beauty! Guava. So local people are doing that.
The young, what? The young leaves or the?
Young leaves. You just chew it.
Young
leaves. The worms gets right. Young leaves. That's the problem with me. I've been nomadic so far, going on exploring that, this and all. But now I'm concentrating. My professor is insisting to write book on medicinal plants. It's on the way. Maybe before completing my research, I'll be doing that book. Completing that book. It's going on under the preparation. Maybe in end of 2012 or end of 2012.
Will it be available here or only in India? Will it be available in Malaysia?
I'm not sure about what I think about. Maybe I can.
But you intend to document the traditional knowledge as well?
Yeah. Yes.
In addition to just identifying the plants,
yes.
You document how to
use,
how to consume the quantity,
yes.
the recipe also will be put into the book. Because the dosage, I think, is very important.
And the complete recipe. The recipe includes the combination, the constituents, and the dosage. And how many days? Everything you have to put it into that. But still, I'm telling you, because this information has been traveling last 5 years. Any steps, some mistakes happen. See, for example, I tell you, if I tell one information to her to have, it goes to the last bench, you just ask her, what is the message I had told to her, it will be coming in different form.
Yes.
So I'm telling you, so that means 5,000 years it has been coming, traveling, maybe some errors would have happened different locations, different junction, different generation. So it's better, 100% we are not going to tell you, take it granted and put it in your system. 100% we are not telling, don't reject it. So let us take it out. You give modern look to the traditional medicine. You examine, validate and give back to it. This is a beautiful exercise. That is why in our country, maybe a lot of traditional healers, we never go all the traditional healers. Now, a lot of business, traditional healer. Because you will, similarly, you have to do this one, validation. Unless validation, no, you cannot take into account everything correct.
Talking about books on medicinal plants and its usage, the Indonesians have published a number of books, especially on the Javanese medicinal plants.
Actually, my aim is that whatever information I collect from the tribal communities, everything I want to put it in the book in an assimilable way. So that may be a base for the future peoples to do research on that. That's the way I've been planning.
I hope you consider publishing e-format,
e-book. Mm.
So,
e-book, okay.
Yeah, so you don't really have some hard copies.
Yeah.
Everyone
will
go.
Yeah.
You see, you know the neem trees?
Okay.
Indian. For that matter, they are Misai Kuching. But we used to, take the leaf from the neem tree and also Misai Kuching.
Okay.
One thing at a time, of course. Boil it, we drink the water.
Okay.
And now I'm wondering, all this plant, when we boil it, when you drink the water, would it destroy the vitamin or the whatever medicinal value that is found in the plant?
Mm.
When you boil it?
No. Actually, what happens, I'll tell you.
I'll tell you.
Even every day, I consume 1 teaspoon of powder. See, actually, this churnam, what you call churnam, once you put it in the pulverizer, the final product is called a churnam. That churnam, when you take 1 teaspoon and put it into hot water, what happens? Hot water, which is accelerating the process of breaking the cell wall and release the substance, release the metabolites out. So in that 2 minutes, 3 minutes maximum, like a tea, if you take a green tea, just put it in the hot water, allowing 2-3 minutes, by the time it gets diffuses. The molecule which present in that particular sachets getting dispersed, coming out. Then immediately you remove and take it. So nothing wrong in that. It's a way
nothing
of extraction.
Wrong with that,
nothing wrong.
You boil it, you can drink
nothing,
the water.
Nothing wrong.
It won't destroy the...
It won't destroy. It's a way of extraction. It's a kind of extraction process. Sometimes you put it in the hot water, sometimes you can put it in the cold water, sometimes you have to put it in the solvent. Ethyl acetate, methanol, chloroform, hexane, so many solvents. So this is one of the method, very simple method, hot water, decoction. This has got its own merit. Nothing is going to happen.
So
metabolites.
From the neem tree is very useful.
Very useful, no, beyond the doubt, no. All each and every part. Neem is, what is that? Even one day, no, it's not sufficient to say what for it is used. If you take the neem flower, you take the neem.
You don't see the flower.
No. White, creamy, small flowers will be there. You just collect the neem flower, just put it in the ghee and roast it, then take it.
Can it grow in Malaysia?
Neem tree is there, no? Is there, and leaf acid.
I haven't seen the flower.
No, it's there. Very creamy white flowers, small flowers. And when it is blooming, you will get the whole tree is in flower. You can take the flower, a handful, then just put it in the key and roast it. Take it. It's very good. Many things. And the young leaf acid, just put it in the mixy. Take the juice and consume. Then tree bark. The bark, aged tree, maybe 100, 200, 300 years aged tree, take the bark and crush it, make kashaya. It's good for diabetics. It's good for diabetics. Neem bark, tree bark, bark. Then neem seeds. The one tree, I think, I would say, in this plant kingdom, there are 2 trees which has got maximum usages. One is palm tree. You know palm tree? Borassus blemlifer. There is one palm tree. Palm tree has got the highest number, then neem tree, so many. uncomparable tree, neem tree.
Berry. What's the use of berry
tree? I'm not understanding what tree you are referring.
Berry.
Berry, no. Berry is a fruit bearing tree. It's a kind of...
The leaf line can eat.
Actually, what I understand, the berry is a kind of fruit. Berry.
Yes,
lot of seeds will be there, juicy fruit. It's berry. It's a general name. I'm not getting what it is. Sorry.
Normally, the plants...
Because the small fruit, the young come on. Hairy one. That is a berry.
I'm not getting it.
Normally, I want to ask you, the herbs trees, the young shoot is more potent than the old one or which one?
See, there are two things. One is, so when I suggest if you go for Adathoda Kashaya, Adathoda Vesica, I said Adathoda Vesica, that's one plant, Adathoda Vesica, which is one of the basic ingredients in cough syrup. Okay, you understand this level?
Cough syrup.
Right. This particular plant, if I ask to take the leaf and do Kashaya, I will be telling you go for first, from the top, first node, the leaf arginase, the first node, leave it. Second node, you leave it. Third node, you take two leaves and make one kashaya. It's an optimum stage of the leaf wherein you will be expecting all the ingredients there, not much of concentration. If more of concentration, it will give you better also. Young leaf may not be having adequate component, may not be good for relieving your disease also. So optimum, that's why everything is beautifully told by the traditional peoples. This information, third node, who told me? Any taxonomist has not told me. The tribal people, traditional people have told me, yes, you take the third node. What is there, the third node? Nobody knows. Why not in the young? We know some sort of reasoning, but why specifically third node? Nobody analyzed. Understand, aloe vera. Traditional people says if it is less than 500 gram weight, don't take it.
500
Less than 500 gram
leaf.
Weight, yeah, each leaf. Each leaf less than 500 gram, not useful for food. You can take it as a cosmetic. But as a food, you should allow to grow at least 500 gram each leaf. I had grown, I should know, 1 kilo in our place. And even I have seen in this Patalangaya Jaya, the shopping complex area, I have seen one place, it's very big leaf. It's there. Only thing, you have to keep one plant in one pot. If you keep 5-6 plants together, it won't have space to spread.
Is it true they said you must grow your aloe vera at least 2 years, then we can
consume? 1 year, 12 months. Minimum 1 year. Minimum 1 year, you will have at least 16 leaves. 16 leaves in one plant. So each one 500 gram, if you look at, so 8 kg, one plant.
8 kg.
Do you know any local researchers who are doing similar work to what you are doing for Malaysian plants?
I'm sorry, that's what I'm not understanding. I couldn't get the correct contact to whom I can intervene. I'm not... But one thing I know, but this ethno-medicinal forest concept that I've been referring here, it's not been established in Malaysia, that I'm sure. But maybe from Forest Research Institute in Malaysia, I've been to Dr. Rashida, she's been working with the medicinal plants, whom I had discussed, and she's also carrying this ethnobotanical documentation. But this ethnomedicinal forest concept has not been established in Malaysia.
Yeah, because I'm sure that there are lots of interesting, useful information here from the traditional folks as well, which is not being
Actually, what happens now, this is happening. The documentation process is going on. Most of the universities are not denying that. But what happens now, it is an effective concept to penetrate into the community beyond the years. That sort of concept now, people have not thought of. And that is one of the effective tools to bring species knowledge together, allow to interact, contact constantly, then it will carry the information for the future generation. So that kind of a vision, I think people are not thought of.
You talked a lot about plants. Do you go into the fungal world as well?
Yes, I'm not an expert in that, but fungus, some mushrooms, one information, the fungus which is colorless, whitish, it is consumable. And Ganoderma, there is one fungus, Ganoderma, which is highly useful for cancer disease, Ganoderma. Medicine has also been produced.
Lingzi.
Ganoderma. Ganoderma. But a lot of useful plants, no? That the fungus is there. But my knowledge is coarse, it's very difficult to identify. So I've been concentrating only in the angiosperm, some sort of gymnosperm, to a little extent pteridophytes.
Because I know in Europe, they already have books documenting the various edible fungi. Mm. My curiosity was whether we have the same kind of species in Malaysia and in Asia.
Malaysia, a lot of species are there, fungal species. Even I went into Taman Negara, my friend went to Taman Negara.
Can I answer for her?
Yes.
Because I work in Frim.
Okay.
You can get that book from Frim. Oh, yeah. It's been published, Edible Fungus. It's traditional knowledge.
Ah, okay. Well, it's there in Frim, huh?
One is good for high blood pressure.
Hyper?
Hypertension.
There are a lot of plants are there. See, I don't know whether you might be having this plant in your place also, Malaysia also. There is one plant, hypertension, that is Tyrosperma, Tyrocarpus marsupium, And I have been seen on the roadside, lot of avenue trees, Tyrocarpus zelanicus, which is there beautifully on the sea, on the roads. There is one species, Tyrocarpus marsupium, which there in the wild, that gum, exudate. You take exudate, you just injure the tree, get exudate. That exudate, you have to put it into the water, okay? Then you remove that gum, you drink the water. That is good. Then even the hibiscus flower I've been referring now, you just take the petals alone, remove the ganesium, throw it out in one glass of cold water the night. You put all the petals immersed. The morning, you take the water drinking, the leaves, no, the petals, you can throw it out.
I eat the hibiscus buds with sambal belacan as ulam.
Uh-huh.
You eat it as a raw. The buds, you know, before it blooms.
Okay.
Just eat it with rice and chili.
That is also good, no?
Yeah, very tasty. Yeah. It tastes like lady's fingers, like okra.
How about sinus? Sinus, running nose.
Running nose, sinuses, a lot of things are there. Again, see, running nose, sinus is concerned. It's a complicated issue. Okay. You have to first identify what is the problem for you.
No, whether it is dusty area, running nose.
Whether it is a physiological.
Like hiking, high heel.
Yes.
Even very cool, nothing happens.
That's what.
When it comes down downhill, the nose is running again.
It's a complex issue to identify what it is. And generally, there are a lot of herbs are there.
Yeah.
So I would say botanically, Arsinum sanctum tulsi, then Adatoda vesica, then Solanum xanthocarpum.
You should have pink photos.
So many plants are there. But photos are there, but at time, no. I'm sorry. And you'll be bored. I'm sorry. More and more, no. You'll be bored also. It's a dry subject also.
How about knee osteoarthritis?
That's what I'm saying. Knee, no. We have a very famous plant in India. Cardiospermum elicacabam. That is.